Hello, let's have a look at how we can convert between denary and hexadecimal. This is a little bit harder than converting between hexadecimal and binary, and it's sometimes forgotten about by students, quite honestly. You have to be able to do these conversions as well. So just to start with the easiest possible question you could get, here we're converting from hexadecimal to denary. Just to remind you that 0 to 9 in hex and denary are exactly the same. So if I'm converting 8 from hexadecimal to denary, it is just still 8 because they are exactly the same between 0 and 9. Between 10 and 15, we use letters. So if I'm converting F from hex to denary, I've got to think about it a little bit more because all you need to memorize really is that A is 10 and F is 15 in hexadecimal, which gives us the answer here, which is 15. And then to work out the numbers in between, you just can use the alphabet to figure that out. Those are the two easiest categories where we have a single digit we are converting. If we're given two digits, it can be a little bit harder, especially because this number here looks like 42. But if a question tells you that number is hexadecimal, it's not 42, it is 42. So we have to do a proper conversion here. Now, the way we convert between denary and hexadecimal is to use the hexadecimal place value table. In binary, our place value table was 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on and so on. In denary, it was 1, 10, 100, 1,000, and so on and so on. Multiplying by 2, multiplying by 10. Because hexadecimal uses 16 digits, in the hex place value table, we are multiplying by 16. So our far right column is always a 1. Multiplied by 16 gives us 16. Now, we would just keep going at this point. 16 times 16 is 256. That'd be the next column. However, at GCSE, we only ever use two columns. So it's a very tiny table, just of two columns, 1 and 16. Once I draw my table, which is always going to be the same for hexadecimal, at GCSE, we type in or we write in our number for 2. And now what the table is telling us is we've got 4 lots of 16 plus 2 lots of 1. Well, you don't get calculators in this exam, so you've got to use either mental maths or written maths. 4 times 16 is 64, plus 2 is 66. So the answer here would be 66. To use another example, this time a more typical hexadecimal number, C8. Well, again, my first job is to draw my table, so I know the place value, 1 and 16. Then I stick in my digits like this and do, well, this time it's a little bit harder because I'm doing C times 16 plus 8 times 1. But what is C? Well, C, if we remember that A is 10, therefore B is 11, therefore C is 12. So really this is saying I've got 12 lots of 16. And I'm adding that to 8 lots of 1. Now, potentially you could do this in your head. If you were to do 10 times 16 is 160. 160 plus 2 times 16 is plusing 32. So we could do that relatively easily, somewhat in our head. But just be careful, please, because there's no calculator. You have to, don't mess up these calculations. It is harder in hexadecimal, so just do workings out if you need to. So it's 192 plus 8, therefore it gives us a nice even 200. That is what C8 is in denary. Okay, so I'm starting with hex into denary because those are the easier of the two conversions, I would say, because you are multiplying. If we were to go the other way round and go from denary to hexadecimal, it can be harder because you have to divide this time. However, again, to start with an easy example, if we were given 13 as a number, this is 13 because I'm telling you it's denary, I'm converting 13 to hexadecimal. Well, 13 is within the digits of hexadecimal, so therefore what is 13 in hex? Well, if A is 10, B is 11, C is 12, D is therefore 13. So this is equivalent to just D. But if I'm given a denary number bigger than 15, I need to use two hexadecimal digits. So if I'm converting 25 into hex, what do I do? Well, my first step always is to draw in my hexadecimal place value table. This time I'm not writing 25 because I'm going the other way around. It's a bit more work this time around. So what I need to do is similar process to how we went from denary to binary. You've got to look at the far left column and go how many times the far left column go into 25. Well, in this particular case, it only goes in one time. Like in binary, I need to find my remainder. So what was left over when 16 went into 25? Well, I've got 9 left over. How many times does 1 go into 9? Well, it goes in 9 times. So the answer here looks like 19, but it's not. The answer is 19. That's what 25 is in hexadecimal. Right, time for a bigger number, 99. Let's put this into hex. So first step, always, just without even really thinking, draw my place value table, and that's my starting point. So you can see now it gets a little bit hard because I've got to go how many times does 16 go into 99? And this is where you might need to deploy some either, well, probably not mental maths ideally here, some actual written maths or workings out. You could do long division potentially. I'm going to do a bit of a mix. So how many times does it go in? Well, let's try 16 times 5. What is 16 times 5 going to be? Well, 16 times 10 is 160 divided by 2 is going to be 80. So it's getting us relatively close to 99. Can we fit in another 16 before 99? Yeah, I can. So I could do 16 times 6 is therefore going to be 96. Can I fit in any more? No, because that's way too close to my number. So therefore, 16 goes in 6 whole times into 99. So I'd write down 6 over here. What is my remainder? Well, the closest I got was 96. My remainder is therefore 3. How many times does 1 go into 3? Well, 3 times. So 99 is equivalent to not 63, but 63 in hexadecimal. Let's do a final example, which is a bit of a nasty one. Same process though, do the columns 1 and 16. And now we're going, how many times does 16 go into 227? Well, again, let's do my little kind of half formal, half informal method of going, well, 16 times 10 is equal to 160. How many more can I fit in here? Can I do 16 times 15 maybe? Does that get me enough? Well, that's going to give us 240. So that is too much. However, if I was to subtract 16 here, so if I was to effectively do 16 times 14, this would give us what, 224? Well, 224 is just below 227. So therefore 14 is the best I'm going to get. 16 goes into 227, 14 whole times. But I can't, well, I mean, I could, but I can't really write 14 down here because 14 is 2 denary digits. And I want to put one digit under each column heading. So what is 14 going to be in denary? Well, if we go the other way around and go F is 15, therefore what's the letter before F? It's E. So 14, I'm not going to write down 14, I'm going to write down E instead, because that's what 14 is in hexadecimal. What's my remainder when this is put in? Well, we're only 3 away from this. So my remainder is 3. 1 goes into 3, 3 times. So the answer this time is E3. 227 is equivalent to E3 in hexadecimal. So this is our hardest conversion, I would say personally, because you are dividing and you're dividing bigger numbers potentially. So my working out is a bit of a fudge. You do whatever method's going to work for you, but use a method. Don't just rely on your head because you may overestimate your powers of mental maths in an exam situation. Be careful, write stuff down and take it slow.